Jazz dance was born in Africa many centuries ago and has had a long and colorful evolution. African dances express feelings of joy, sadness, or high celebration. In the late 1800s, the cakewalk was an African-American dance done for the prize of a cake. During the early 1900s, vaudeville shows developed the cakewalk into an intricate couple dance, showing off fancy footwork with inventive struts. The use of the rhythms and movements of African dance, combined with Irish jigs and British clog dancing, developed into the percussive footwork of jazz tap dancing. Starting from the birth of jazz in New Orleans, the Dixieland band sound traveled up the river to the windy city of Chicago to become the steamy, sultry sound of the blues.
And she would sing the same song every time she got up there. But we all loved her anyway. She weighed about 200 pounds, you know what I'm talking about? And she used to sound something like this.
Didn't I buy you a brand new Eldorado, baby? And I gave you all my dough.
In West Side Story, a Broadway musical that opened in 1958, choreographer Jerome Robbins and composer Leonard Bernstein immersed themselves in the characters and atmosphere of the updated Romeo and Juliet story told against the warfare of teenage street gangs in New York City.
Beat it!
We would like to present The Rich Man's Frug from the 1960s Broadway musical Sweet Charity, choreographed and directed by Bob Fosse. During the 1970s, disco became very popular with such dances as The Bus Stop, Hustle, and Bump being done to the music of Donna Summer and the Bee Gees. In the 1980s, jazz dance entered the commercial world as companies started to use jazz dance to grab audiences' attention for their TV advertisements. The 1990s were a time of expansion, when old ideas were expanded upon to create something new and different. You will be the creators of the new style of jazz dance, and we look to you to further this art form as so many Americans have done before you.
Yes, young man. How do they jump so high? Eugene, why don't you answer that?
Lots and lots of practice.
Do you guys practice every day or do you have weekends?
Every day. Lizzie, do we practice every day?
The company rehearses Monday through Friday from 9:30 until 4, but most of us do like extra gigs, like different shows, and we teach a lot, conventions, stuff like that on the weekends. So we are dancing 7 days a week.
How do you memorize the dances?
Kimberly. Kimberly's going to answer that. How do they memorize the dances?
It's just like if you were to have to memorize an essay in school. You just keep repeating and repeating it until you know it. So it's basically just like in school. We go to rehearsal every day, just like you guys go to school every day, and we just keep doing it over and over until we finally get it. And hopefully we get it.